hurricane. Ian will make it, even though he's cleaning, and you just see his butthole.
But he'll be here.
We're just gonna Photoshop out his butthole.
It's right here. Oh.
Sorry, I had a little too much energy. Stay tuned. Welcome to Common Man Cocktails. Dan, Derek, and Ian are gonna make for you a cocktail. It's called the Hurricane. We made one 9 months ago. We're making it again.
But it's gonna be different.
We're using a red Fassionola syrup from BG Reynolds.
Instead of what?
Instead of passion fruit juice.
See?
Last one we used Light Rum passion fruit juice.
Yep.
Available at AustinDrinks.com. But guess what else is available at AustinDrinks.com? That stuff. Red Fassionola.
Red Fassionola.
So there's a reason why that matters. What?
Strawberry.
What is it? Great question. Put some of that in there and try it.
All right.
So these are also new that I just bought. Now,
it's in this.
These, see the difference here? This is for, I now carry two different Japanese double jiggers. Actually three, because we stole the old one. This one's a little bit more expensive, like $3 more, because it's polished and it's from a higher end brand.
Shiny.
But it has all the same features as that one. Bitter, tangy, boom.
Yeah.
Right, but also has like a...
That's like strawberry.
Mm. Yeah, so it does have a strawberry taste, and I don't even think there's strawberries in here. It's cherry juice, it's passion fruit, cherry, and sugar, and mango.
It's good.
So the passion fruit is just passion fruit. The Cocktail and Sons, when I did a hurricane that uses Cocktail and Sons hurricane syrup, which is just rum in their syrup, is a strawberry base. So something tells me like the original Fassionola was probably a base of strawberry of some type.
Okay.
The recipe for this, by the way, is 2 ounces of dark rum, 2 ounces of light rum, an ounce of fresh lime juice, an ounce of fresh orange juice, an ounce of Fassionola syrup. If you can't get that, passion fruit syrup, and a bar spoon of grenadine for your color, a little bit of sweetness, because it's got a lot of alcohol in here. 4 ounces of alcohol and only 2 ounces of everything else and some sugars.
Did you ready to put grenadine in?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So, if you've been to New Orleans.
Spoon?
You want a spoon?
We said a bar spoon.
Spoon!
Grenadine.
Oh, I eyeballed the bar.
Okay.
Sorry.
No, I figured.
I thought you were asking me to stir it.
Put it all in a cocktail jigger.
I could stir it, but we're shaking it.
Put it all in a cocktail shaker. Shake it for like 15 seconds, nice and chill. If you have a hurricane glass, like the cool hurricane glasses that are smaller, it's probably better. The only ones I have are the Pat O'Brien's hurricane glasses. They're freaking huge. You're going to need like 20 servings to fit in there. And Pat O'Brien's doesn't make this drink this way anymore, so that's a problem.
But they're good.
You'd be destroyed if you made this in those big glasses.
Oh, my God.
Oh, you'd
be dead. No. Yeah. No.
So the idea behind this, and you'll appreciate this because it's not necessarily a pandemic type worthiness, but during World War II, there was a shortage of things. All these people are fighting. There's death everywhere. Like, businesses can't all run. Why don't we put it here? As they usually do.
Right to the job.
And so what happened is there was a huge shortage of whiskey. So you had a shortage of whiskey and scotch, which is what Americans were drinking at the time. In the 30s or whatever. So, when was it? Yeah, World War II. So, late 30s. So, they had a lot of rum. Surplus of rum. So, distributors started saying, you want whiskey? We'll give you a case of whiskey, but you need to buy 2 cases of rum. So, people had to buy their 2 cases of rum to get the whiskey they want. So, as they're still getting their clientele that wants whiskey, they're creating this massive surplus of rum. How do you get rid of a massive surplus of rum? Pat O'Brien was like, hey, I know how to do that. We'll invent a drink that's juice, sugar, and a shitload of rum. Problem solved. And the hurricane is born.
Mm.
It's normally in a hurricane glass. It looks like a lantern, like they use during hurricanes. What? That was your drink? What are you, nursery rhyming over there?
Yep.
Nursery rhyming.
I don't know. Apparently I was an old woman who lived in a shoe once. I don't understand, but...
It happens.
Do you need to take a picture of it before it's all gone?
No, it just happens. It's like magic of
when Jen gives
this one's better than the
on
other
camera.
One.
That's what
Wait, what other one? Oh, the one we made last time.
The one we made last time.
So yeah. I think
that one's definitely better.
That's because passion fruit's tartar, more tart.
Yeah.
So you get a lot more high, like a stronger acidity and a stronger bite from it. And I. I've had a problem with passion fruit because it's so tart.
I thought you liked passion fruit.
Oh, I love passion fruit, but sometimes it's really fucking tart, and you can't even consume
it. It's more tartar.
So there's the...
It's more tartar.
It's tartar.
Like, you could get...
You could call it tartar sauce.
I was actually waiting
more
for that before.
Sauce.
But now it comes out. The Have you ever having a passion fruit where you taste it and it's super delicious?
I don't eat passion fruit.
Why? Because it tastes like eyeballs?
Oh, you don't eat passion fruit?
And saliva?
No, I eat apples and oranges, but I don't eat passion fruit.
Passion fruit's awesome.
I'm very simple in my grocery habits.
Okay, then.
But you probably would eat a passion fruit.
Yeah, I'm not afraid of it. I'm just,
yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's the deal.
I've seen you eat flowers, so.
Passion fruit. Passion fruit in
That's
the Dominican.
Way too expensive for something I'm going to eat in 2 seconds.
Not only that, you're going to scoop it out, eat all the seeds, and it kind of tastes like weird. Like it's got a weird texture to it. But when you add sugar to it and everything, it's great. The problem is, if you get them in Dominican, they're like sour, more sour than like a lemon. Mm. Like it's, you scoop it in your mouth, and you're like, I really don't want to, what am I going to do with this now? It's in my mouth. Right? So you have to like just put it down. But then you have another half that you have to eat. Now you're like,
it's not the first time I've had a mouthful of regret.
Is there anything else?
Call back to college.
There I think go. That was a couple shows ago.
A couple nights ago. Yeah.
So, what I'm saying is it's pretty tart. Passion fruit can have that tartness. Pieces of eight. Cocktail. Hold on.
Wait, where is the pieces of... Dan's dying over here.
Pieces of eight?
Yeah, it's a cocktail. Yeah. It's got a lot of passion fruit in it.
Yeah.
Look it's up there.
You're like at least 15 seconds late, but it tends to have
the
alcohol delay.
It's got the tartness factor. It's pretty tart. When you add this, the limes and stuff, it gets tart. This, with the Red Fassionola from BG Reynolds, available at AustinDrinks.com, tastes better because it doesn't have as much of that tart flavor, so you're getting more of the juiciness.
Yeah, the only really tart thing here is that lime juice.
Yeah. It took me like
More about balance.
5 minutes to say that after all this, but there we go. It's not as tart as passion fruit. But it's harder to get unless you get it at Austin Drinks or wherever else
you Well, now you can get it from Austin Drinks, and it's better.
Right. And you can get both, and you can compare.
Yeah.
But if this is sold out or you have passion fruit, try it with passion fruit. It's just a little bit more tart. And maybe you can cut it with sugar instead of, you know, half passion fruit, half sugar, or simple syrup, something like that, to kind of get around it. But this has a little bit more full
or
flavor.
A little bit of strawberry jam in there.
You can't...
You get the sugar and the flavor. And,
No, I can't poke holes in that logic, man. That's a pretty good idea.
I said it.
Plus, you get that red, deep red color.
Do you have strawberry jam?
No. That's outside. My grocery list.
I was going to say, that's in the grocery list?
I have peanut butter, though.
Yeah. Mm.
You don't want to throw that in here, though.
No.
So that peanut butter bourbon. No.
Whiskey.
Peanut butter whiskey. No, that's good. So, the total package here, if you said, I want this drink. I don't want to make it. I'm going to New Orleans. I'm going to go Pat O'Brien's to get that drink. You are going to be sorely disappointed.
It's going to be
get,
sweeter.
Yeah. Yeah. It's going to be refreshing because it's hot and humid as fuck down there.
Yeah.
If you go in July.
Yeah.
And apparently they don't think it's hot enough because they have fires all over the courtyards.
Yeah.
It's
That's
gorgeous, but.
Ambiance-y.
Yeah.
So, the you know what the funny thing is...
And you think you're going inside, and everything's really outside still.
Yeah, I've never actually sat inside. I've only sat out on that patio.
I know. Because you don't want to be outside in July in New Orleans. You want to be inside in the AC.
Yeah. The doors, I mean, it's all open, so it's probably still hot in there. I don't know. I think the only time I've ever... No, even going to the bathroom, they have those ones under the staircase that are scary. Mm. Like, have you been to the bathrooms in the Battle Rights?
I don't think I did.
The girls' room has like double doors, gold crested, gold leaf. You go to the guy's side and it's like on the edge of a stairwell going down. And like it's right in here and you open the door and you're like
pissing in a gutter.
Closing it. And you're like trying to piss. And the
You're always just out
ceiling.
In an alley.
Yeah.
And the ceiling is right here because the staircase is like right in front of you and there's like a urinal you just get to shoot for. And I'm like, this is insane.
And that's Derek talking about having a crouch while he pisses.
Look,
it's not a short joke, I'm just saying.
It's entirely
there's some
a short
taller
joke.
People out there. Yeah, giving context.
Right. But the end, that doesn't even experience the drink. The people there were nice. Like, I've never had a problem with the waitstaff. Waitstaff.
Yeah, they were fun. Yeah.
And they're happy and they're always, you know, whatever.
They have to be.
That's true. Okay, fine. They're paid to be happy.
I'm not saying they're faking it, but it's that kind of place where you want the happy, interactive waitstaff.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So they get the right people.
Yeah.
But the drink.
And they'll give you all the popcorn you want.
It's true.
I never.
Well,
I
have to stop up all those hurricanes. People.
The hurricane.
Well, it's salty. Makes you want to drink more.
Exactly. The hurricane is in this big glass, and it looks like Kool-Aid. It's just bright red.
Has
doesn't look anything like this. Ice and
it's
red sugar water.
It's a lot. It's a big drink.
It's a lot.
Yeah.
It's like every other drink you get on Bourbon Street. It's overly sweet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Underly alcoholed, and not extremely
does
complex.
Does it light up?
Yeah.
But you can keep the glass, which is cool.
Yeah. True. So you walk out and they let you buy the glass. So you get your souvenir glass of a drink you can never fill again unless you maybe blend it so you get more volume with the ice. This is a better drink. It's basically what I'm trying to say. Better drink.
Take a drink. That, I think.
Better people, better drink.
You can make drinks that big. Yeah.
I could. I can do that. Give me the glass.
At the end. So there you go. If you want to get yourself some Red Fashionola or passion fruit or both or whatever, you can go to awesomedrinks.com, use coupon code TIKI2020, save yourself 20%. That's 5% more than you could save last month. So if you bought last month, buy again.
Do it.
It's an extra 5%, which is going to save you like, I don't know, $3.
Right? On order, what,
$60? Order more.
Yeah.
If you order more, then it's you save more.
Nah. Yeah, he just explained math.
Subscribe to the show.
He just did that with math.
I just did math for you.
Are we still drinking?
Timothy Frey is our Patreon Patreon subscriber. So shout out to Timothy for subscribing to our Patreon.com/CMC account and sending me money so I can buy alcohol like this so they can make this episode for you. Otherwise, I didn't have any Bacardi.
True.
Right? Is that feisty enough for you, Ian? He's already fucking cleaning. Fuck that guy. Sidebar, more videos.
Shit.
Down below is the bartender starter kit. Get your starter kit, get your fashionola, get your drink on. We're teaching you how to drink. I said drink twice.
Drink.
Three times.
You're drinking a lot.
Four times.